This is three people.
Oh boy.
Idiot.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Chemical Reactions. I'm Chuck.
And I'm Juliet.
Back to instrumentals today with, I guess we'll do a song by Rush. We have two of them on the list, so let me ask you a question, Juliet. Do you prefer shorter, more rocky, or longer and more moody?
Shorter, more rocky.
All right, perfect. So we'll do YYZ. Link will be in the description below if you want to listen to the song for yourself. Let's go! A triangle.
That's the only instrument I can probably play.
Upbeat notes. Baseline. Yeah, he's a god. Alex.
Okay. There was a lot going on.
Yeah.
In that, it just sounded very, like, adventure theme to me.
Well, yeah. So I guess the piece of trivia. What happens when you put a top 10 best drummer with a top 10 best guitarist and a top 10 best bassist?
You get a game show theme song.
I was going to say you get Rush. Rush, ladies and gentlemen. So, YYZ, the only reason why I bought moving pictures, and for context, I already had the retrospectives 1, that was 74 to 80, and retrospective 2, that was 81 to 87, I don't know, something like that. And YYZ was not on retrospective 2. I needed to have YYZ. So I bought moving pictures, the album, which, by the way, probably one of the best Rush albums of all time. You know, Tom Sawyer, Limelight, or some great songs, but YYZ was the one I was missing, so bought this album.
Yeah, it was just, it was a lot to take in. I was like, oh, yeah, just more and more instruments.
This is three people.
Oh boy.
Yeah, that's three, like, people.
Three one-man bands.
Just... Yeah, because Geddy Lee's playing the bass, and then once in a while he has a hand on the keyboard.
Yeah, I'm just imagining, like, in Mary Poppins, like, Dick Van Dyke's character, how he has, like, all the instruments on him. Just, like, three of those.
Yeah. Yeah, and, you know, Neil Peart's drum set is, like, you know, toms, like, two bass drums, of course, a gazillion cymbals, like hi-hat, he's got a xylophone, I think, and like bell cow, so he's got the whole assortment. He's like, you know, you can barely see him behind all this thing. It's like, you can play everything behind there.
I think it just wasn't dark enough for me.
Well, that's why I offered to begin with.
I want my music to sound evil.
Yeah, all right, so I think we're going to have to do La Villa Strangiato together when we get to it, probably in a couple of weeks. But yeah, La Villa Strangiato is definitely a lot more moody, kind of sentimental, you know, a bit more of a tearjerker. So you'll get that there. This is a, you know, display of musicianship.
Yeah.
Higher beat, you know, than what La Villa Strangiato is, which is also, by the way, a display of musicianship, but a bit closer to like David Gilmour, Pink Floyd type display of musicianship rather than just speed and general awesomeness. Yeah. So, apologies. So, every once in a while I get a lot of comments saying, I'm going too insane. Sometimes I can't help myself. This was one of those cases. And that was me trying to hold it back, by the way. So, you know, it is what it is. You want a reaction, you're getting a reaction, people. This is my reaction. All right, cool. I think we're gonna leave it here. Anything else to add?
Nope. I just want my nachos.
There we go. Nachos waiting. So I'm gonna please drop down some comments below what you thought about the reaction, what this song means to you, for those of you who heard it before today, and then for those of you who might have heard this today for the first time, let us know your first impression, and then, you know, stay tuned. If you haven't yet, subscribe to make sure you don't miss anything from us coming later on from this instrumental series that we're on, and click on notifications to make sure that you're alerted as soon as our videos drop. And if you enjoy this video, give us a like, follow us on our social media, and thank you so much for spending a few minutes with us. We will see you next time on our next video.
Peace.